really been a very eye-opening morning for me. I know many of you, by reading your work, listening to your work, and seeing various emails, it's really great to actually be able to connect some faces to some really important issues. I want to tell you about a website that we started about 7 months ago this weekend called Austin Talks. And the idea was fairly simple. We wanted to write and report about a community that many of us either live in or live near and feel very strongly about, that it's not depicted by the mainstream media in the way that people actually are living in that very rich, multidimensional place. And so basically day in, day out, we report and write stories, post photos, a few videos. We're still looking for more videos. I'm just trying to give people a voice and have people hopefully talk to each other. And we didn't really know exactly what we were getting ourselves into. I am co-publisher of another website called Chicago Talks, which is primarily covering local issues and underserved communities, and also neighborhoods that get covered, but we usually write about issues on that website that no one else is paying attention to. And that's primarily done by a bunch of students at Columbia College where I teach. That's my paying job. As many of you know, in this kind of work, it helps if you can find a job with benefits even that can pay you so that you can do these things that you really want to do. But I'm very fortunate because at Columbia I can do both things. I can get a paycheck and have health insurance and teach a whole new generation of students who also, by the way, are teaching me many things about how we can better tell the stories day in and day out of all of our communities. It was very interesting to me to hear Victor say earlier that each one of us is a media network. We don't have to wait for some legitimate source to speak the truth. And that, I think, actually captures very well what we've been trying to do at Austin Talks. There actually are, like some neighborhoods of Chicago, Austin actually does have some weekly newspapers that cover it. And our intention was never to come in and duplicate the good things that they are doing. We were simply interested in filling the void because there's so much information day in and day out about all the places we live in that just doesn't get covered. And in fact, we formed a partnership with the Austin Weekly News, and by that, we simply post stories on our website that they have published in their paper, and then they have published 30-some of our stories. We've produced about 150 original stories over the last 7 months. Many of them have been published in Austin Weekly News, which has been great for us because not everyone in Austin and many other neighborhoods has instant access all the time to high-speed internet. And many people still get their news the old traditional way. And so that was helpful to us to be able to form that partnership. We also work very closely with a number of groups in Austin. South Austin Coalition is one in particular. In fact, if you go to our website today, you will see that we're running a banner headline. They were our very first banner headline promoting an event that they're having next week. And in turn, we're going to have the opportunity to run an ad in that program. Those are not new ideas, and I know maybe you've been doing that. But what is new for people like me who come from mainstream media, that's where I spent most of my life, is the idea that we're not in competition. And although I think none of us see each other as part of this competition and we want to work together, I would even argue we don't even want to see the Trip and the Sun Times as competition. Now, they aren't always as open to forming partnerships with us, but for instance, our blog, our Austin Talks website has a place on the Chicago Now blog. And I'll be honest with you, I don't know how much traffic we really get that way. We get a lot of it from the search engines, and that was a really important point made earlier. If you don't know SEO, and I'm learning it and teaching it myself, and learning from many other people, Community Media Workshop has had some great sessions on it as well. So make sure that you get yourself educated, and it takes like an hour to really figure out and start doing. We started doing things differently in the last month. In the last month, we had 4,600 unique visits, which is pretty phenomenal since we've done absolutely no marketing at all. And I attribute a lot of that to just search engine. If you smartly include links and if you label your stuff and tag it right, it gets picked up. And a lot of people find your stuff that way and hopefully come back. I wanted to mention a couple other things in terms of challenges that we face for the future. And I think they're probably similar to many of the challenges you face. Money. Well, it's nice that I have a job. I I'm not the only person working on Austin Talks. And there are many people who are volunteering their services or are getting paid. We have a grant from Chicago Community Trust. But as all of you know, grants run out. I'm waiting to hear back if we're going to get a little bit more money for next year. I'm assuming we're not going to get another dime from them. I'm very happy that we got the money we did from them. But at some point, it's going to run out. I want to be able to pay people. I really strongly believe in the work that we do, that no one really should do this for free. That's great if someone wants to upload a photo or produce a video for me for free. But their time and their energy and their thought matters and should be compensated. So one thing I'm trying to figure out is how we actually fund it long term. And if I had the answer to that, I would be speaking and to the Google folks, and I would be making a lot of money in consulting fees. So that's the big question. I'm really looking forward to your questions and maybe hearing if anyone has an idea about not only how we can work together, but how we can actually fund these things long term so that we don't have to be reliant on foundation support. We don't have to be reliant on a group of wealthy individuals that, God love them, they're out there giving their money. But I think the more we can have a collective funding of what we're doing, the better for democracy. Thanks for having me.